second thing that you may do to affect your sleep, and it involves the heart, right? Look at this wonderful organ back there. It's pounding away. It's the most magical. That's why I went into it as a specialty. It's the most poetic organ. It's twisting and turning. Now, here's the question. Do you think sleeping on your right side is the best or the worst way to get a good night's sleep?
I think it's good because I'm just on my right side.
Yes. You sleep on your right side.
Yes, I do.
You think it's the best way to go?
I think so.
All right. It turns out that sleeping on your right side is, in fact, the best way.
Yes.
Here's why. Sleeping on the right side of your body gives your heart a little extra room, so it doesn't have to function so arduously. I'll show you why. Right? For most people who are, you know, it's not a big deal, but if you've got heart failure, this becomes a big issue. Sleeping on your left side becomes the worst way to get your night's sleep. And here's why. Let's say this is the heart, okay? I want you to hold this in front of you. No, no, it's like that. That's your chest, okay? That little balloon in there is the heart. See it there?
Okay.
Now, the heart beats. So we have your beat. Okay?
Is that cool?
Yeah. Now, I want you to turn over on your left side like you're going to sleep. You see how the balloon touches the chest wall?
Chest wall, yeah.
Wow. There's not much room there anymore. See, there's no room. And I lift it up to get it off the chest wall. And now, look, put it on your right side. Lie on your right side. Not a big deal.
Yes.
You have plenty of room here. Lots of room. Not a big deal. That's great. Thank you. And so you end up with not as much space in your chest cavity as you desire. They actually studied this and showed that people who laid on their left side compressed their heart and had more problems with heart failure. So, okay, for the average person, it may not be a big deal, but you got this tip. Take advantage of it.